We'll discuss about general solution of cos x equal to k and general solution of tan x equal to k. Now, let cos x is equal to k, assume that it is cos alpha. So, cos x is equal to cos alpha, cos x minus cos alpha is equal to 0. Now, here you apply transformations, cos c minus cos d minus 2 sin x plus alpha by 2 sin x minus alpha by 2 equal to 0. So, sin of x plus alpha by 2 equal to 0 or sin of x minus alpha by 2 equal to 0. Now, we know that if sin x equal to 0, general solution is x is equal to n pi. So, x plus alpha by 2 is equal to n pi or x minus alpha by 2 equal to n pi. Now, x plus alpha is equal to 2 n pi or x minus alpha is equal to 2 n pi. So, x is equal to 2 n pi minus alpha or x is equal to 2 n pi plus alpha. So, combining these two, x is equal to 2 n pi plus or minus alpha. Therefore, cos x is equal to cos alpha implies and implied by x is equal to 2 n pi plus or minus alpha, n belongs to z. This is the general solution of cos x is equal to k. Now, let us come to tan x is equal to k. So, let tan x is equal to k, assume that this is tan alpha. Now, this is tan x is equal to tan alpha. This is sin x by cos x is equal to sin alpha by cos alpha. Now, go for cross multiplication. This is sin x cos alpha is equal to cos x sin alpha. Now, bring this term to LHS side. Sin x cos alpha minus cos x sin alpha is equal to 0. From compound angles, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b equal to 0. Sin of a minus b equal to 0. That is, sin of x minus alpha equal to 0. Again, general solution of sin x equal to 0 is x is equal to n pi. That is, x minus alpha is equal to n pi. X is equal to n pi plus alpha, n belongs to z. Therefore, tan x is equal to k implies, you can write x is equal to n pi plus alpha, here k is equal to tan alpha. Now, n belongs to z.